The four filmmakers that have had a major impact on the way I look at films and also served as inspiration for my own style are Denis Villeneuve, Edgar Wright, Ryan Johnson, and Bong Joon-Ho. Each director has a very distinct style that I find very interesting, and analysing them has given me more of an idea of what they do to achieve their goals as filmmakers. Denis Villeneuve is a French-Canadian filmmaker who has greatly impacted my views on the role of a director, as his approach to filmmaking is that of an auteur. He has a very distinct visual style that features muted colours and long takes, yet they still remain beautiful. He doesn't rely on dialogue to tell the story, but instead uses visuals and actions of the characters. And the dialogue that is used is simple but still effective. Watching his films, such as Arrival, Sicario, and particularly Blade Runner 2049, showed me just how much control over a film a director can have, as everything is personal for Villeneuve. These films have inspired me not to be afraid of disregarding established styles and create my own instead. I can see myself becoming a director in future, as it's already one of my strengths, as I enjoy having direct control over what I'm doing and being able to help people achieve my creative goal. When most people think of Edgar Wright, they think of his editing style. Much of Wright's storytelling comes from his fast cuts and quick pans. It is integral to the way that he constructs scenes and executes visual comedy. While some may not like his editing style, I think it's an important one to analyze, as it taught me about rhythm and pacing of scenes, as well as understanding editing as a film form. Wright also uses music as an important part of many scenes in his films, and often chooses to cut to the beat of the music, like in Shaun of the Dead and Baby Driver. As a result of studying his films and editing as a film form in general, I have taken on parts of his style and can see myself becoming a film editor too, as I find that being able to construct scenes in certain ways and getting the pacing and rhythm just right is very satisfying to me. A filmmaker who likes to tackle specific genres and their conventions is Ryan Johnson, whose five feature films so far have all fit to a distinct genre. Looper is a science fiction time travel film. The Brothers Bloom is a con man movie. The Last Jedi is a space opera, and Knives Out is a murder mystery. However, his debut film, Brick, from 2005, is a neo-noir detective movie heavily inspired by the works of Dashiell Hammett, all in terms of plot, characterization, and dialogue. He wrote the dialogue as if it were a Hammett novel and rehearsed with the actors prior to production, as it was harder to memorize. Despite this, Johnson made the setting a high school, with students fitting the film noir archetypes. I find this fascinating as to how a filmmaker can take elements from a genre and do something completely different with it. I want to explore something similar in future projects of my own, with sci-fi or fantasy, as I find mixing genres with elements unrelated to one another is such an interesting idea that can produce more interesting and original films. I enjoy the way that Bong Joon-ho incorporates real-world problems into his films, which not only makes for interesting subject matter, but makes the audience think about what they've just seen. Bong's screenplays are excellent in the way they represent ideology. In his 2013 film Snowpiercer, Bong is able to explore the effects of climate change and how society tried to fix it using climate engineering, which ended up creating a new ice age in 2014. Then we flash forward to 2031, when the only surviving humans are stuck on a train that circles the globe, and if it stops, everyone dies. Which is ironic, because pollution and technology got them into this situation in the first place. While the film also talks about class structure, with people at the front of the train representing the wealthy, and the tail end passengers are the poor. Parasite is Bong's film that perfectly captures the social injustice experienced by lower class South Korean families. I think that the way in which Bong is able to show these injustices, while also making both rich and poor families appear to be the parasite, is phenomenal and something I wish to be able to capture in my own writing. As I'm quite inexperienced, I find looking at Bong's work to be very insightful, as his thematic messages are powerful and characters are written in such a way that represents their struggles or lack thereof. I find writing is one of my weaknesses that I'd like to improve on. As I try to make my messages subtle, they often end up being very overt. Another aspect I wish to improve on is my cinematography skills, in terms of conveying my themes. I'm never sure if what I'm doing is aiding or hindering my intent. Bong's ability to storyboard every single shot in Parasite astounds me, as he thought about how each one impacts the story he's telling and the way it helps the film's themes. As a result of watching these directors' movies, my knowledge of film has improved, and I now know what my goal will be as a filmmaker. To not only make interesting and entertaining films, but to make them without sacrificing my own vision and not worrying about current filmmaking trends. As well as utilizing editing and music as a means of exploring the story and not just to get from shot to shot. And finally, I want to make films that leave a lasting impression not only on the audience, but the world.